Serious news tonight on Afghanistan as Mitt Romney committed without any qualification to the idea that troops should be withdrawn from Afghanistan in 2014. This is a reversal for Mr. Romney in terms of his previous stated conditions on that idea. He'd previously said, "I don't think you set hard and fast deadlines." That was to ABC News on July 29th. He said, "I think the biggest mistake he," meaning President Obama's, "made in Afghanistan were, one, announcing the specific date we would withdraw." He said that in February. He said, "This president has done an extraordinary thing. He announced the date of our withdrawal. That was wrong." That was at a South Carolina Republican primary debate. Mr. Romney today just flat out reversing his previous objection to there being a withdrawal date from Afghanistan as he very tightly hugged President Obama on everything from drones to Egypt, to Syria, to a number of other matters tonight on which there was less disagreement than we might have expected before the debate. Chris Matthews, what's your take on how these two candidates did tonight?
Well, let me take my favorite role for a minute, my role of critic. You know, you think about the United States. Let's talk about our country instead of the Middle East and all the other, and Israel that was focused on far too much tonight, Israel. Let's focus on the United States. Nothing about the drug trade coming through Latin America, which is the greatest threat to our culture in many ways, drugs and how they come to the United States. The failure of European finance, which is always hanging over us every day. We get new stock market worries about Europe. No discussion whatever of Europe, of Latin America in any way. No discussion of the BRIC countries, all of them, and their new economic challenge to the United States. It was all relentlessly on something that was referred to by Romney relentlessly, almost robotically, as the tumult in the Middle East and Iran. Anybody, any jackass can talk about bombing Iran. They never talked about the consequences of what we do after we do bomb them. That's the question they never even talked about. Again, very quickly, I thought Romney had a strategy tonight, avoiding looking like a radical, avoiding the statements he's made throughout the primaries and caucuses that put him on the far right in terms of looking a bit dangerous. He pulled back, pulled back, pulled back. Obama was very good on Bin Laden, as we might have expected, very good on the $7 trillion, which will be added to the deficit. To the deficit you already have. Very good on education. Very good on the Iraq decision. Romney was very good on the economy. Obama didn't seem to have a good comeback on the economy very well throughout tonight. Again, I was disappointed. It was sort of a pandering operation on Israel over and over and over again. Say it two or three times, not 20 times, about Israel being our number one ally. Going over the president's itinerary and how he didn't stop in Israel gave Obama an opening. So my basic concern was it didn't talk about United States security. It didn't talk about drugs. It didn't talk about European economic problems. It didn't talk about the BRIC countries who are really challenging us, Russia included, India, of course, Brazil. No talk of the modern economy and the real economic and cultural and military challenges to the United States and the financial ones. It was all about the same little area of discussion. I thought it lacked any kind of originality and importance.
Chris, what do you think happens with Mitt Romney and his right flank, if he even has one anymore, for him to be saying, we don't want another Iraq or Afghanistan, we don't want any military action in Syria, we don't want any military action unless we absolutely have to in Iran? He's reversing himself on some of those previous stands in a way that I think he would not have felt comfortable doing during the primary campaign. Are there critics on his right who get upset that he got up there and said, I like Obama's foreign policy on everything, including Syria right now?
Well, I think they're more political than either you or I. I think they hate Obama. They want him out of the White House more than they want to destroy Al-Qaeda. Their number one enemy in the world right now, on the right, is their hatred for Obama. And we could go into that about the white working class in the South and look at these numbers we're getting the last couple of days about racial hatred in many cases. This isn't about being a better president. They want to get rid of this president. That's their number one goal, and they're willing to let Romney go to the hard center, even a bit to the left on issues, as long as they get rid of this guy. Romney went in there tonight with 16-ounce gloves. He didn't want to look too ferocious. He just wanted to win. And the way he wanted to win was not make himself into the right winger that the right wing that's supporting him really are.